This is the Japanese garden. It's actually linked to the Chinese garden by just a bridge. And it's tucked away in a corner in Jurong. My fondest memory of the Japanese garden would be back in 1986 when my late husband and I took our wedding photos here. And I have not visited the Japanese garden until 2011 when I was diagnosed with early stages breast cancer, and I joined the Qigong group, and the Qigong master brought us here to practice our Qigong, and subsequently I have been coming back here sometimes in the mornings and sometimes in the evenings to practice on my own. The other thing that brings kind of a sad memory for me was also in October 2011. I lost my dad, and it is here that I can reconcile with what has, you know, been going on in my life and what I've been going through. The loss of my husband, the breast cancer diagnosis, and even the loss of my dad. I can safely say now that spending time here alone gives me that peace and a lot of things to be thankful for, including my two beautiful children, as well as, you know, nursing myself back to health. I actually hope that I will not see a land for sale sign when I, you know, walk into the garden someday. I cannot imagine this place being taken away, because I think we will never be able to find any other parks in Singapore with lots and lots of pine trees. And to me, that was, you know, the selling point for me, that you know, because it is here that, you know, I found healing, I found myself, and I found forgiveness.